Hello, and we're at Epcot today. Oh, the ball just shut off. Maybe there's a show happening. Let's see if we caught one. They keep these lights on the ball. It's just so good compared to what they've done in the past, so hopefully get to keep it. Okay, so today's our first time seeing Christmas at Epcot, and look at the ball. Isn't that so cool? Little candy cane colors. So we are gonna go. Ooh, and they put lights out there in candy cane colors, so I guess those lights match. Let me show you. Those lights, those little poles match whatever's happening on the ball. So as always, you want to grab your passport. Let's see if I can find it. All right, here. We might start the cookie stroll today. I don't think we'll finish it, but they have added new cookies. So that's a part of the holiday cookie stroll. But I'm excited. The holidays are here.
I guess so,
guys. These walls are going bye-bye. Very soon, next week. So today's the 1st. On the 5th, these walls are coming down. And we won't be blocked off to the other side of the park anymore.
he should be able to just walk right through. So, last time you're gonna see them. That's cute, they put a little Christmas store on the other side. So, I wanna go to the Odyssey.
The ornament.
Yeah.
The Odyssey.
I don't know if I should go this way or this way. Because you can't cut through, you have to go. Let's go this way. I swear, I think at this point I've been to the parks thousands of times, right? And I'm always still learning new. I didn't realize there was a walkway right here by like the entrance to the World Showcase. I always thought you had to enter through like by Creations or by Mexico. I thought that was the only ramp that was connected. I always just walk right past this, and it's not very well lit. So, and it's completely, oh, this is why I don't know. It's completely blocked off. I never noticed that this wasn't a functional walkway. So we're going to the Odyssey first. See what goodies they got. Wow, they have a lot just here at the Odyssey this year. Very cool. So they have a red velvet mini bunk cake, so salted caramel, spaceship earth cookie. We had that last year. That wasn't bad. Mouse crunch, mint chocolate mousse reef, which is that. Chocolate covered toffee, apple caramel crumb cake, pepper pinwheel. And they do always have alcohol options. Peppermint cocoa or peppermint schnapps. All right, it is packed in here. This is definitely where you want to be. Oh, Santa's walking around. How freaking cute. Oh, so his last showing is at, he ends at 6, says here on the calendar. But just to show you, Mom, want taki? Alright, so this is all the cookies and fun stuff. But I think we might try a little later. The line is really long and we are limited on time. But we'll come back.
Okay.
So stay tuned to the next video. We're gonna do the Odyssey then. We only have 2 hours of park time, so we kind of have to go a little quicker than what the Odyssey can provide. But how cute was Santa? He stopped. And his last time was 6.
What time is it now?
7:27. So he stayed an hour and a half already. So if kids walk up to him, he will stop and take pictures with them and talk to them. Super cute. So no worries. We're gonna check out Santa again. We're gonna bring Emmett that for that trip. So maybe he can meet Santa this year. All right, we see the Epcot tree. Very cute. And it has these like 100 bulbs on it. Very cute. First stop, Nochebuena Cocina is a new booth this year. I'm already loving what the menu says. So we're right there. So right behind Creations, you're gonna find Nochebuena Cocina. All right, the Nochebuena Cocina. We got a tamale, plain glazed churro, plant-based cotija cheese and spicy red chili sauce. Benin, mojo pork with a tonic and ketchup mayonnaise, spiced chocolate cookie. And it's a part of the cookie straw. And then ponche navideño, Mexican Christmas punch with apples, pears, guava, orange, dried hibiscus, brown sugar, tamarind, and cinnamon sticks, and clove, served warm. They have an horchata beer? What? All right, let's go
test. All right, we got the tamale. Excuse any noise, we're right next to test track. The tamale has the plant-based chorizo, plant-based cotija cheese, and spicy red chili sauce. I didn't read the part where it says spicy. So I'm hoping it's not too spicy. Mom, you want to go first? Okay. I don't want to.
Let's get some of the sauce.
Go in carefully.
It's spicy, but not spicy like hot.
Yeah.
It hasn't hit me.
No.
So, it tastes really good.
So it has a little kick to it?
Just very little, because you could taste like a little sweetness to it.
Oh, okay.
So it's not spicy, huh?
Ah, okay. Mom going in for the second bite.
It feels like it has a little like hot sauce to it.
Yeah.
But it's not strong at all.
Okay.
Yeah.
How did you like the flavor overall?
Oh, I liked it. Yeah. Tastes really good.
Did you know that this isn't real meat?
Really? Oh.
Yeah. Wow. And it tastes like real meat.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah.
Good. Not real cheese either. Like, if they had cheese, it's not real either. This is entirely vegan, plant-based.
Oh. Give me another one.
Good.
They're really trying to encourage the plant-based meat because, you know, less emissions, I believe that's the word. Basically, it's cleaner, better for the planet to eat less meat. So I think that's why they kind of have a booth all the time. And of course, there's a ton of vegans, and they should have an either as well. So.
I know what you mean. The sweetness.
Yeah.
It's almost a little barbecue.
Yeah.
I took a big bite. So la masa is a little
thick.
So you gotta take it slowly, but it's not that spicy. I was getting afraid because Disney has been getting more bold. They had the impossibly hot wings. And that ruined Mark, that ruined Ty. Like, Mark was out for the comp for the day with those wings, and he only ate one wing.
Wow.
That's how bad it hurt him. Hurt his stomach, his inner lining, everything. He was not a happy camper. But this is nowhere near. It's just a light little...
Yeah.
In the back. But it's good. I would have thought this was me. Mm-hmm. Same mouth to feel and everything. It's good. So last year they gave like two tostones and like a little bit of panin. And I feel like... So this year, instead of putting small on bits, they did one giant one and a ketchup mayo sauce, because last year was super dry without any condiments. And then they put another, I think it's like it's a mojo sauce. So this is pork. Benil is pork shoulder. Tostone is a fried plantain. Green plantain.
Do I have mayonnaise on my lip?
No.
I can feel it.
Okay. I'm going in for a second bite. This is so good. Seasoned, right? Not dry, even though it's been sitting here for a little bit. But the mojo is, not the mojo, the pernil is like very flavorful. It feels like mom made this pernil. Mom, did you come to Epcot? And cook the penne this morning?
No.
Let me find out if you got a side job. Try it, Mom. It's good. It's salty. You taste the mayonnaise. The mayonnaise is definitely, the ketchup mayo is good with it. The totón. It's a little dry, but totón can be really dry, depending how long it was sitting there. But the flavors. I'm tasting like adobo. I'm tasting, which is like onion, garlic, powder. It's all a mix. Really, really good.
Yeah.
Picking it up.
Tastes good.
Right, but they did it right.
Mm-hmm.
Like that's how it's supposed to taste.
Yeah. Plenty of meat on it too.
Sometimes I'm not gonna lie, you know, this thing doesn't get it quite right. You know, like there's always a kick, a moment that's missing from the flavor of Latin cuisine.
Because it all depends who's cooking.
Right. And even if, like, yeah, that's the point. It's like it, you need to understand the culture to understand the flavor. Mm-hmm. And so if you can't, it's kind of hard to mimic. You can follow recipes all you want, but sometimes it's just not about the recipe, right? Mm-hmm. It's about just knowing how something should taste and what the flavors, yeah, right? And knowing the flavors that you grew up with, right? See, second bite. I told you guys, it's good. You don't want to stop. It's really good. I think that was just $5.50 too. Not bad for, you know, and that's a fairly large portion. And we always split, so I think it's a decent. I think Christmas time they get a little more willing to be in the holiday spirit and not charge us so much for. But what did you think? It tastes good?
Yeah, it tastes really good.
All right, and we also got the ponche. A ponche navideño, which is basically a Christmas punch. And it says it here, Christmas punch with apples, pears, guava, oranges, dried hibiscus, brown sugar, tamarind, cinnamon sticks, and cloves, served warm. So they gave us in a hot cup. I can feel the fruit moving around in there. Oh yeah, look at that. Whoa. You can really see the color. Let me get that cinnamon stick. Look at a whole orange. Wow. Okay. And so it's non-alcoholic, right? It was only $5, so yes, it was only it is non-alcoholic. Yeah, there's no alcohol in here. Dried hibiscus. So it's a tea. I like hibiscus tea. Do you like hibiscus tea?
Mm-hmm.
So let's put that back on. Actually, let's sip it without it because it's smoking. You see the steam? Mm-hmm. I was like, multiple reasons. Ooh, I want to go to bed now. I just want to hold this in bed. Just what a nice sweater. If today was cold, like it was for Jollywood when we went to Hollywood, this would have been life. Oh, sorry, Mom. You want some?
It does taste good.
Right?
The apple and the cinnamon comes together.
Oh, yeah. And the hibiscus, you feel it. Did you taste it?
Yeah.
It's a little bit at the end, the aftertaste.
Right, right. With the orange.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The citrus. Ooh, I might have to look this up. We might have to do this for Christmas.
Tastes really good.
This really good. Put a little rum in it. Wow, this is good. And again, this was just $5, so far we've only spent $18. So it had to be less than five, right? We got four things. I know the cookie's only three.
Yeah, exactly.
So the drink must have been three.
5, 10, 15, 18.
18, so yes, it was five.
My math. Mom came to the rescue on that one. All right, so we did get a cookie. We got the, let's see, the spiced chocolate cookie. Now I'm hoping this is the abuela chocolate that I wanted so bad from the cheesecake at Hollywood for Jollywood. It was supposed to be Mexican hot chocolate cheesecake. It just tasted like chocolate cheesecake. Mexican hot chocolate has a, like, kind of the red heart cinnamon flavor, which is really good. So let's see. It doesn't look great. And I don't know what, oh, it has like bits in it. Can you tell?
Yeah.
I don't normally smell food because I find my sense of smell is a little strong and I tend to not like the smell. So I'm not a person that goes, ooh, let me smell it first. But it kind of just came in over me when I got close to it. It smells good.
It doesn't say anything about the cookie.
No abuela chocolate, but I will say I think those bits are white chocolate. So it's a chocolate cookie with white chocolate chips. So it's a chocolate chip cookie but backwards. And it has some icing on top. Not bad.
What do you think? Tastes good, but I wish there was more chocolate flavor to it.
Yeah, it's just sweet. Mm-hmm. I think it could have done without the icing on top, and maybe we would have gotten more chocolate flavor. But because it's just like sugar icing on top, it's like really sweet.
Yeah, tastes good, but to get it again, no.
No, it's not one we're going to be like, oh my God, I hope they bring in extra.
Mm-hmm.
For sure. So overall, Nochebuena Cocina, what's your rating? 1 through 10?
Well, since we didn't like the cookie that much, I will give it an 8.
Okay. I think that's fair. Yeah, everything else was good. I'm going to give it a 9. It's starting early. This is a good booth. The cookie, I'm only gonna dock it because it's still good cookie. I'm only gonna dock it 1 point. I can't dock.
I gotta dock it 2 because I'm a chocolate.
Oh yeah, lover. Yeah. She's offended that you don't taste the chocolate.
If it's named chocolate, it has to taste like chocolate.
You heard it here first, all right? But it's true, we're not getting the best of luck with the Mexican chocolate, right? The dishes is just not having enough chocolate. But overall, it's still pretty good. So yeah, I'm still gonna dock just 1 point. The tamale was good. The tostón with pernil was good. This ponche just awoken a whole nother world for me. I just, you know, when Remy, do you remember Ratatouille when he finds the Gruyere cheese with the mushroom and he gets blasted by lightning and then all of a sudden the colors come out of him, like he's like, oh my God.
Amazing. Each flavor was totally unique. But combine one flavor with another and something new was created.
My mouth is dancing with flavor. That's exactly what happened when I drank this. All the colors came around me. The world looked just a little brighter for a
just
second.
Just like the cup, huh?
Oh, yeah. See? All these colors were surrounding me in real life when I took a sip. All right. Next up, we're going to take some pictures, some video. Always follow me on other socials. If you're here on YouTube, I'm on Instagram at StephRed89. I take pictures and videos and I always do character greetings and stuff, so that's always fun to watch. And I'm on TikTok as well, same name. If you go on my YouTube, it'll all be linked down below and go check those out. So we're gonna have some fun, take some photos, and then I think
maybe we'll stop at one more place. I kind of really want the Odyssey really bad, but I should really save that when I have more time. It was just very busy. So yeah, I have to look at the pamphlet to see what else we're gonna eat.
All right, so we just got our sundae.
Well, use one hand, you don't need both.
All right, so we got the peppermint hot chocolate sundae, which a sundae. Would this be considered a sundae? Or just a cup of ice cream with some whipped cream?
A cup of ice cream.
I thought it was gonna come with like
a swirl of chocolate.
Yeah, like something like fudge on it, nuts on it. I also then realized as I got mine that this is the free item that you get when you complete this cookie stroll. So we just paid for it. Wah, wah. $6.25. I mean, it's a good portion. It's not, I don't think it's like, but isn't like the McDonald's sundae like $3? I'm just saying. I'm just saying if you're giving it out for free, it should not cost $6. Because I probably just paid for everybody's sundae that went in that line to get the free one. But let's try it since we're here. Here's the chocolate we've been wanting. Okay, I'm not so mad that I paid $6 for it. Because it is good. The peppermint is not so strong, but it's like the perfect. It's like a junior mint, right? The chocolate mint, but like a little less strong on the peppermint. Try it, Mom. Okay, so you can get that at the sweets and the holiday suite. That's the only one that's going to be open after 9. I personally thought that the park usually closes at 9, so all the food closes at 9. But today, the park is closing at 9:30. So I thought the booths would stay up till 9:30, but they don't. So lesson learned, we learn. So we only got to try 2 booths today, but that's okay. We're coming back earlier in the day so we can spend more time, eat more food, drink more drinks, have a great Christmas at Epcot. It's my favorite time of year, so I am so excited. I do have a new job that is a little bit more strict month scheduling, but I'm gonna make it work. Making it work, we're gonna try to hit both, every park, all 4 parks, twice in 1 month, which is a lot. I usually do like 1 park once a week, every other week. Okay, just for reference. So we're doing 2 parks a week and we're doing Universal included. So now it's 3 parks a week. So I'm excited to just enjoy the holiday season. So come along with us and join us to this. It's just the beginning. December 1st, it is here. You guys like my ears? We are ready. We're getting a good goodbye. New show. This is for Christmas. We enter with a show, we leave with a show.
That's what the thing is.
Together, they're my favorite.
great time at Epcot. A short visit, but that was okay. We got to see the tree. We got to do a few, two booths. We did pay for a free treat, but that's all right. It was good.
It was very good.
Yeah, it was really good, so it was worth it. So yeah, with that being said, I hope you guys liked the video. My name is Stephanie, and thank you for being a part of my world.